there's a story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down. And I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there. I'll tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel-Air. In West Philadelphia, born and raised, on the playground is where I spent most of my days. Chilling out, maxing, relaxing, all cool and all, shooting some b-ball outside of the school. When a couple of guys who were up to no good started making trouble in my neighborhood, I got in one little fight and my mom got scared and said, "You're moving with your auntie and uncle in Bel Air." I whistled for a cab, and when it came near, the license plate said fresh and it had dice in the mirror. If anything, I could say that this cab was rare, but I thought, nah, forget it, yo, home's the Bel Air. I pulled up to the house about 7 or 8, and I yelled to the cabbie, "Yo, home, smell you later." Looked at my kingdom, I was finally there to sit on my throne as the Prince of Bel-Air.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Today on CVTV, Spirit Week shirts, swim and gymnastics team sign-ups, and clubs this week. Hey CV, I'm Tanner Hunter.
And I'm Stephanie Montini. Make sure you buy your pink out shirts before October 4th. Forms are in the office. Short sleeve shirts are $10 for sizes small through extra large, and 2X are $12. Long sleeve shirts, small through extra large, are $17, and double X are $19. There is not a spot on the order form for extra large long sleeve shirts. Please write extra large in the quantity off to the side. You can turn your money to your academic study hall teacher or Bree Bailey, Sam Nicholson, Kennedy Bauer, or Elena Marvin.
Spirit Week shirts will be sold Tuesday, September 28th through Friday, October 1st, during both lunches in the cafeteria. Ms. McCracken and Mrs. Kramer will be sitting at a table against the wall.
Shirts will be $10 for sizes small through extra large, $11 for 2X, and $12 for 3X. Make cash and checks payable to CVHS.
The themes for Spirit Week, starting Monday, October 11th, with PJ Party, Trick or Treat Tuesday, Wear a Hat Wednesday, Throwback Thursday, and Fan Friday. If you have any questions, please see Mrs. Kramer or Mrs. McCracken.
Anyone in grades 9 through 12 is available to join FBLA. See Ms. DeLon and NA202 to sign up.
The Bay Club will meet Friday, October 1st, and every other Friday following.
Any girl in 9th through 12th grade interested in participating in gymnastics this year should sign up in the high school office by this Friday, October 1st.
CVNHS will be collecting gently used or new hoodies beginning next week through October 8th. The hoodies will be donated to St. Vincent de Paul Society and the Salvation Army. They will distribute them to their clients. Everyone has at least one hoodie that they no longer need. Please consider donating and warm up someone else's phone.
Hoodies may be brought to North B 114, Ms. Jones's room. Attention anyone who is interested in swimming or diving for CV. Please pick up a flyer in the main office for important contact information and dates. Please let Mr. Pulochak in the middle school know if you are interested in being on the CV swim and dive team.
So all the announcements we have for you today, CV. Now on to Olivia and Bryce with the sports.
Hey CV, it's Liv.
And Bryce here with your sports for today.
Last night, girls volleyball beat Hopewell 3-1. Alyssa Porter had 15 kills and Macy Lotmer had 31 assists.
Girls golf beat Ambridge and Seton LaSalle 191-241. They are undefeated in section champs. Congrats, girls.
Tonight, boys soccer plays at South Fayette. Varsity starts at 7:30.
This morning, girls tennis plays Blackhawk in the section doubles at 9:30. Good luck, girls.
Tomorrow, girls soccer plays at home against Freedom at 6 o'clock.
Volleyball plays home against Beaver at 7:30. Come support.
Girls golf has a match against Blackhawk away at 3 o'clock tomorrow.
This Friday, the girls tennis team has their senior night against Riverside at home at 2.
Football plays at home again against Quaker Valley at 7 o'clock. The theme is to be announced.
That's all we have for your sports today, CB.
Here is Zach and Tanner with a segment on Club Hope.
Good morning, CB. I'm Zach.
And I'm Tanner. And today, we'll be giving you some more information on Club Hope.
Club Hope was started by Mrs. Brown during the 2019-2020 school year. This was an effort to get our school involved in a much greater cause.
Recently, they have been making cards and collecting snacks to give to the patients after their treatments.
On Fridays, the club meets in Mrs. Brown's room, NA 206, to discuss the upcoming events and what she needs help with in the club.
This past weekend, the club attended a Home Run Derby fundraiser to raise money for the Club Hope Foundation in Elwood City. There was a young girl from Beaver Falls who is currently battling cancer who threw out the first pitch to start out the event.
Mrs. Brown has given us some approval to interview her about Club Hope.
What's going on, CV? I'm here with Mrs. Brown, and she runs Club Hope here at our school. So, Mrs. Brown, why did you start Club Hope?
I started Club Hope because I had a cancer diagnosis myself. Actually, two, breast cancer and bladder cancer. And there's this foundation in Elwood City that does really wonderful things for people that have a cancer diagnosis, so I wanted to have a little part of that here in our school.
So for the students that might want to join the club, what are some things they should know?
So anybody can join, and what we do is we make cards, and we bring snacks over to Allegheny Health Network, which is located behind the Beaver Valley Mall, and those are given to patients who are undergoing chemo treatments. And then we will volunteer for the foundation that is located in Elwood, and they do all kinds of stuff. They have events where they raise money, and then they send cancer patients gift cards and gift baskets, and they'll clean their house, and they'll do anything, give wigs to chemo patients, whatever it is that they might need. And we will also fundraise for that group as well.
If you or a friend are not part of a club already, or have decided to join another, Club Hope would be a great choice.
If you're interested in joining, visit Mrs. Brown, NA 206. Have a great day, CV.
Hey, CV, welcome back. I'm Mitchell Gagne.
And I'm Dom Galatas. Today, we will review the word of the week for September 27th, 2021.
This week's word is embellish.
Mitch, what's embellish mean?
Embellish is to add exciting details to a story.
Where did the word embellish originate from?
It originates from Latin language.
Now, can you use that word in a sentence for me?
Dan doesn't trust the news media because he believes that most reports embellish the facts.
Wow. Thank you, Mitch. I can't wait to use that word in my everyday vocabulary.
That's all we've got for you today, CV. Have a great day.